Welcome, everyone. Let's begin our lesson for today by going over the learning goals and success criteria. First, what are we learning? We're learning how to recognize patterns in a round-robin style tournament in order to count the total number of games played, how to use repeated reasoning to expand the tournament to include more teams, and to relate word problems to probability functions. How are we learning it? Through the round-robin tournament part 1 notes and the round-robin tournament part 1 assignment. When can we use this information? To set up tournaments for your future children's sporting events, and to predict outcomes of events at work and in your personal life. How do you know you learned it? By getting a score of 4 on the Round Robin Tournament Part 1 assignment. Now let's take a look at our agenda for today. We will begin by going over our learning goals and success criteria. While we do that, you'll fill out your Get It Started. After that, we'll go over the Round Robin Part 1 notes, and then I'll give you time to complete the Round Robin Part 1 assignment on Desmos. At the end of class, we'll go back over our learning goals and success criteria while you fill out your before you go. Your only homework for tonight is to begin working on the reasoning with relationship study guide and any incomplete assignments that you may have. Let's take a look now at the Round Robin Tournament Part 1 notes. The notes begin with the learning goals and success criteria. So here's the scenario. A local soccer tournament is played in a round robin format where every team plays every other team. Assuming that every team plays every other team exactly once, how many games will be played among the 10 teams? Explain your strategy. So that's what the question is asking us. So a couple strategies to try. Number one, solve a simpler problem. So this could end up being a lot of games. So maybe start with 5 teams instead of 10, and then see if there's a pattern that you notice. Draw a diagram. So maybe you start with 10 and you start drawing lines to the other games. So you can use a diagram as well. Make an organized list and count the games. Look for any patterns you have previously learned. So anything that you've learned in any type of math class that might help you with this. See if there's any patterns that you recognize. And lastly, try to see if there's an equation or function that you already know to solve it. And you may not have all these. You may not be able to use all of these strategies. These are just some to try. So try out 2 different strategies to complete the question. Solution. There are exactly 45 games that were played. And the way we know that is by using combinations. So if you remember back to probability, we can use combinations, which says 10 times 9 over 2, or 10 factorial over 8 factorial, 2 factorial, because we're doing 10 choose 2. So that's 10 factorial over 10 minus 2 factorial over times 2 factorial. Another way you can write it is 10 choose 2 using the combination. Let's talk now about how to sign in to Desmos to complete your work. So what we're going to do is you're going to click on the link to go to the assignment, and it should take you to a page that looks kind of like this. And right here where it says sign in with Google, we're going to click there. And it's going to pop up with our email accounts. You're going to click on your school email account, and it should already have you logged in because you should have already been logged in using Google Classroom. From there, I'm just going to click start the activity, and it will take me into the assignment and allow me to begin. So that's how you will log in to Desmos using Google. Let's take a look now at the Round Robin Tournament Part 1 assignment. The assignment begins with the learning goals and success criteria. If we scroll down, there's a link here to take you to your Desmos activity. Go ahead and click on that link, and it should take you to a page that looks like this. We'll go ahead and click Start the Activity. The activity begins with the learning goals and success criteria. We'll go ahead and click Next. Here's the instructions. It says a local soccer team is playing in a round-robin tournament format where every team plays every other team. Assume that every team plays every other team exactly once. So we'll go ahead and click Next. It gives the instructions again. How many games will be played among the 10 teams? So you'll go ahead and solve this. So use any strategy you want. Some of the strategies that you can use were given in the notes. And when you do that, you'll go ahead and solve it and state the number of games. Let's say that there comes out to be 50 games. There's not, but let's assume that's what it was. You'll explain your strategy. How did you arrive at that number? Then you'll click Next. Then it says, Casey wondered how many games would be played among 20 teams. So we found 10 teams. Now we're adding 10 more teams. He reasoned that it would be twice the number of games for 10 teams. So 20 equals 2 times 10. Is Casey's reasoning correct? So would it be correct to just double the number of games? You'll have to decide whether it's true or not and then explain why. So you'd go ahead and say no, for instance, and it would hit submit and explain. And then you would hit explain your thinking. You would explain why he's wrong. So that's what you'll do for this activity. Once you're done, you'll go ahead and go back to your Google form and click next. This will take you to your before you go. Go ahead and fill out your before you go and then submit your work on Google Classroom.